Hello guys, I hope you're doing good. It's another fantastic day out here. So today I want to talk about in-text citations. I want to tell you what they are, how and when to use them. But before we go into that, if you're new on the platform, please hit the subscribe button and also turn on the notification bell so that every time I upload a new video, you will be among the first to know. If you're regular, thank you for coming back. So let's go straight into it. An in-text citation is a reference made within the body of a paper to alert your readers of a source that has informed your writing. So clearly, you can see the word in-text means within the text. So it appears within the paper, you know, within the paper, because at the end of the paper, you will have the full information regarding every source that you used to write your paper. The exact format of an in-text citation varies depending on the academic writing style that you are using. For example, APA, they use the surname and the year of publication as their in-text citations. For example, Kenya is one of the most developed countries in Africa. It boasts some of the world's best tourist attractions, most successful athletes, and high-end coffee and tea, into bracket, a Sony, comma, 2020, close the brackets, full stop. In this case, the citation is part of the sentence, and therefore the full stop comes at the end. MLA, they use a different format. They use the surname and the page number. For example, Kenya is one of the most developed countries in Africa. It boasts some of the world's best tourist attractions, most successful athletes, and the best coffee and tea, into bracket a Sony 215, close the bracket, full stop. In this case, you can clearly see the in-text citation is a Sony and the page number, which means that the information you are referring the readers to is from a document written by a Sony, and the information is available on page 215 of this document. It could be a book, or an article, or just any other material that you can access the page numbers. We also have other styles, including Chicago and another one called IEE. For Chicago, they use superscripts and the footer function. In this case, you will insert using the Word tool for insert a footnote. It will insert a superscript where you want to insert your citation, and it will automatically open the footer where you will paste the particular reference. So in that case, you will first go to Google Scholar, you pick out the citation, the reference rather, and then holding it in your clipboard, you will click where you want to insert it. And remember, in this case, you have to first put the full stop. The citation comes after the full stop, and then you insert just when your cursor is at the full stop. You will go to references on your Word, and then you go to insert a footnote. You'll click there, it will automatically insert a footnote, a superscript, and also open the footer where you'll just paste your reference. In this case, the footer corresponds with the particular in-text citations which you have placed, and it has a placeholder which will be the superscript. It will continue like that. The next point you insert another one, it will automatically insert a 2 instead of the 1, because it's continuing to count 1, 2, 3 and onwards. Now, coming to IEEE, they use a placeholder. You just insert the citation within the text. In this case, however, you don't insert the surname or the page number of the year. You just use the square brackets to insert a placeholder. In this case, you'll place 1 because that is your first reference. And then on the reference page, that particular reference will be the first one in your list. The next reference will insert a placeholder number 2 for the second reference, and so on. So that is all about in-text citations. Now I want to talk about where do you use in-text citations. There are quite a number of things that will inform you where you will be using your in-text citation. The first and the obvious way or factor is the question itself. The question itself will tell you how many index citations or references you must have in your paper. So in this case, if you are writing a 10-page paper, the instructions might be that you use at least 10 references. So in this case, you will use 10 references, which will automatically correspond to at least 10 index citations. And you will decide where you place them. You will decide where you distribute them. So you'll have some paragraphs having maybe two or three. Another paragraph may not have. So remember, you don't need to put an index citation in every sentence or in every paragraph. You will use the question as your guide. If the question wants you to have five, decide where you will place them. But again, you can cite one article as many times within the paper as possible. But every time you cite a paper, that's still the same reference. So for example, if you're citing the Aswani document, you can cite it 10 times. But that does not mean that those are 10 references. It just means those are 10 citations, index citations rather, of one document, of one source. So if they want you to have 10 sources, make sure you have 10 sources. But these 10 sources, you can cite them within the document as many times as possible. The idea here is that at least every citation you have on your index citation must have a full bibliographic information at the reference page. Also, every reference list you have in your reference page must have been cited at least once within the body, which means it must have at least one index citation. The other factor that will also guide you is when you make a very important claim. When you make a very important claim, it could be controversial, it could just be important. For example, you are claiming Kenya is one of the most corrupt countries. That is a very important claim you are making. So you also cite that because somebody might want to know where you got that information from. So remember, whenever you are making a very poignant point, you are making a very important claim, a very crucial claim, always cite that claim to avoid any revisions, to avoid somebody wanting to know where do you get this information from. Also, another factor that will guide you is when you have read something that is interesting and you like your readers to also get to read it. So in that case, you'll also include a citation at the end of that idea. Could be an idea, could be a sentence, could be a paragraph. So whenever you've read something that you feel it's interesting, just go to cite. Just put there because your readers might want to read more. And having the index citations and the full reference at the reference page will actually help them to get that particular file. You will also have an index citation whenever you quote or you borrow from another source. It is just good for academic integrity to acknowledge other people's work. So whenever you have referenced a material, even if the question is not asking you to have citations, even if you're not making an important claim, even if you don't feel like you need to allow your readers to also enjoy the particular material that you read, just cite whenever you quote, you paraphrase, you borrow from another person's ideas. Always have index citations embedded within the essay and also the full bibliographic information at the bottom. Just one thing about IEE, Google Scholar has not yet updated to IEE. So if you go to Google Scholar, you will not likely find a citation for IEEE, but I've noticed it looks more similar to MLA, so we'll just pick the MLA citation for now. But if you go online, you will see their formatting, you see how they format their references, and you'll be able to also replicate the same. So this is all about index citations. If you want to watch more about my videos about academic writing, be sure to subscribe. Also share my content across your platform, it may help someone. And if you want more, always reach out. I have my email address in the description box. You can reach out through the email address. I'll also drop in my number. If you need personalized training, you can also get that at affordable prices. So until next time, stay safe. Chill out.